This video is about cloning. I've showed you cloning before here on the Event Lighting channel. Primarily, we have cloned preset information, cloning colors, cloning gobos, cloning all kinds of different stuff. In this video, I'm going to show you the traditional way of cloning, coming out to a venue, cloning your fixtures from one type to another, adding new types into your show and stuff like that. There's a few different ways you can do that, and I'm going to go through all of them. So make sure you stick around and watch all of it, because there might be some good information for you if you are starting out with GrandMA3. But let's just get right into it. First of all, as you can see here, I made a small show, and I'm just going to show you right now what's in the show. If you go into our patch here, you can see I have some Mac Viper XIPs, and that's it. And then I programmed a sequence down here, and I'm just going to show you what's in it. The first one is a start cue. The next one is where they just go down, slow fade, down to a stage position. Then they go into a what I call a slow song. It just starts panning nice and easily. Then we have a chorus. We have a phaser running. We have some MA tricks running. Then we can go into our verse where they simply stop. Then we can do our slow stuff here. And forgive me, I just gave it some names and some cues just to prove a point here. You can see they another phaser running here. Then we go into bridge, and then they should start tilting up and down and turn off the intensity phaser. Then we can go into a static look, and then we can go down to stage position. And I didn't store anything at the end cue here. So that's basically our sequence. And this will work if you have a lot of sequences and a lot of songs. This is how you can clone your fixtures. But let's get started. As you can see, I went back into my first cue, and the first way we can clone something is to go into the patch and simply copy the fixtures. We have our Viper XIPs here. I can just mark all of them and say copy. I can go into new fixture and say paste. And now we have some cleaning up to do, because now we copied all the fixtures, we pasted all the fixtures in again, and now you can see we have a problem with our patch, for instance. It did copy the addresses, but they are of course on top of each other now because they are identical, and of course we can't have that. So we need to fix this stuff. We can say patch to 3.1, like this. Now we don't have any patch conflict. And as you can see here, we have 701 through 712. And no fixture numbers down here, because we cannot have the same fixture number twice. So we have to give these guys a fixture number as well. And we can give them 801 and say please. And that's basically it. Now we cloned everything. The only thing we need to do now is to specify what kind of fixtures we want to clone to. So if I go up into my patch here again, and you can see the fixture type is a Mac Viper XIP, of course, because we just copied it. So we can go down here, mark all of them, right click and go in and find something different. Let's say we want some Roby fixtures, we want some Megapoint, we want some BMFLs in a 16-bit version here. We select it, and now you can see we change the mode here, and also down here we can see we have a 16-bit mode. As soon as I exit the patch, this would be stored into our show. Before we do that, we can just show our 3D positions, and of course, when I select all of these guys, they are exactly on top of the other ones, because we clone everything, the X, Y, and Z position in 3D and all of it. So what we could do here is just take them down a little bit so we can see them better. So now we have cloned all the fixtures. As soon as we exit the patch, like this, we now have twice the amount of fixtures. So if I go through my show again, you can see they now do exactly the same thing as the other ones. We have our slow song here, we have our chorus, we have our verse, we have our slow cue, our bridge with our small tilt, our static view here, and then they go off. So this is the first way, simple way you can clone something. And that will work if you come out into a venue and you want to keep your original fixtures, because you can just change your original fixtures into other fixtures, but then you might, if you do it a lot of times, lose some information. Let's say you are cloning all your fixtures into a fixture that doesn't have an iris, and you use the iris all the time. If you clone to a fixture without that parameter, it will be gone. So that's why it's not necessarily a good idea to clone it into fixtures. There are ways you can get that information back, but in general, I would also always keep my source fixtures to make sure that I don't lose any information. That is the first way we can clone stuff. Let's do the next one, which is a little bit more intuitive, where you can decide what you want to clone, if you don't want to clone to all sequences, if you don't want to clone to all groups and stuff like that. So let's, first of all, let's just go in here and delete all the fixtures we just cloned. We say delete, we exit the patch, and now you can see they are gone again. If I turn this off here, you can see I made a group with all the fixtures in it. I also made a group with the odd fixtures, and I also made a group with the even fixtures. And that's just to prove how cloning works. If you clone everything, if you did like we did before, and we just copy the fixtures, everything will be the same. But let's say we do it in another way. We go into the patch again, and we don't copy any fixtures, we just patch some new ones. So we right click here, we take our BMFLs again, we select them, we specify how many, we give them a fixture number, and we patch them at 301 again, and we say please, and then create. Now we patched the fixtures directly. And because we patched them directly, they are not set up in 3D, so we can do that. If I mark them all here, you can see they are on the floor. I can take them up into roughly the same height. We can space them out from from minus 6 to plus 6 meters. So now we patch them. We clear this, we save and exit, and now you can see, if you can see my 3D here, I'll show you as good as I can. You can see we now have twice the amount of fixtures. But the problem is, if I select 801 through 812, which is our new fixtures, if you see all the presets up here, as soon as I press select, you can see they only know the universal preset. They have no information on positions, gobos, colors, iris, anything, everything is gone. The only thing that remains is everything that is universal, and I've covered that in previous videos as well. But if we clear this stuff here and say, how can we get the information back? We want the information back. And what you can do is go down into this one and say clone, and that will open up the clone window. And the clone window is quite simple, actually, once you start getting used to how it works. You have your source fixtures here and you have your destination fixtures here. So the only thing you need to do now is to decide what you want to clone to what. So we can, in this case, to make it easy, say 701 through 712, which is our original fixtures, the ones we had before, all our Viber XIP. As soon as I select that, that's in my programmer now, I can say add selection, and you can see they are now here in our selection. Then you can, if you want to, move stuff up and down to make sure that they are in the order you want to. Maybe you are cloning 12 fixtures, which is 6 fixtures on one truss and 6 fixtures on another truss. So it kind of matters in which order it does stuff. Here you can move that stuff up and down to make sure that everything clones to the right one. But let's clear this, and you can see when I clear, everything stays here because I selected them and I added the selection to the source library, basically. So what I can do now is say 801 through 812, which is the new fixtures we patched. I select that and I say add selection over here, and you can see they it automatically positions 701 opposite 801, 702 opposite 802, and so on. And again, you can move stuff around so you make sure that they clone to the right one. Over here, we can kind of select what you want to clone. So we can say all sequences. In my case, I have only one sequence, but if you have a lot of songs, a lot of sequences, you can select all of them and just clone everything, or you can deselect some of them if there's any point in doing that. The next one here is all groups. Of course, we have our group with all our Vipers in it, and we had our group with all our odds and evens. And if we leave it like this, it's going to clone these fixtures into these groups as well. The next one is our presets. You can see here we have our dimmer presets, which are the absolute, universal presets. We have our position, we have our gobo, we have everything here, and you can select none of them, or you can go in and select all of them, or you can cherry pick which ones you basically need. Worlds works the same way. In my case, I only have one world. Layouts, the same. I haven't used layout in this show file. But again, here you can go in and cherry pick whatever you want. As soon as everything is done here, you can just say clone show. And you can clone with high priority, low priority, including dependencies, stuff like that. I usually just clone it with high priority, but that's all up to you. And that's it. As soon as we close this one and we clear everything here, we have now cloned our show. So now if I select my group here, it contains all fixtures. And if I select my odds, you can see, and my evens, everything is cloned. And if I just go back into the dark mode here and I now run my sequence, you can see now it contains all of the fixtures because we cloned everything. And again, you can decide what you want to clone and what you don't want to clone. That's all up to you. But this is basically how easy it is to use cloning on GrandMA3. And I encourage you to try it out and experiment with how it works and what you can do and what you can't do. So that's today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please give it a like and maybe even subscribe to EventLearning. That's going to help my channel with all these indications to YouTube that it's something people like and it's going to spread it out to more people. But until I see you next time, I hope you have some happy programming at home. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.